Hello students, a very warm welcome to yet another exciting journey of learning English grammar. Today we are going to learn about simple tenses, but before we start, let's begin with our warming up activity. So for that, what are we going to do? First, we are going to practice breathing exercise and then we are going to dismiss the activity by the clapping activity. So are you ready? Good. Sit in a comfortable position, straight, erect, with your spine erect, and then close your eyes gently, put your hands on the lap and sit comfortably. Now focus on your breath, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Very well done, students. Now it's time for us to dismiss this activity. For that, just finish the clapping activity. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So, students, I hope you liked it. Now let's continue with the pearl of wisdom. So what is the thought that I have got for you today? It says, good manners are a way to show other people that we respect them. Now what do we understand by this thought? We understand that we should all the time behave properly and treat everybody respectfully. And this is the only way which shows them that you are respecting them. So kids, I hope you will apply this thought into your lives and follow the instructions of elders. Students, you all have learnt about verbs in your earlier classes. So what is a verb? A verb is an action word, right? So look at the blackboard. What have I written? I get up at 7 o'clock. I eat my food. I read my lessons well. I played cricket. I will get ready for the next day. So, can you identify or spot the verbs in these sentences? Yes. In the first sentence, I get up at 7 o'clock. Get up. I eat my food. Eat. I read. I played. And then I will get ready, will get ready. So these all are the verbs. But did you observe that these verbs are all in different forms? So before we get into the actual lesson of simple tenses, let's understand the verbs and their forms. Students, look at the green board now. The verb in the base form, or it's called the main verb, we write it like this, is play and go, for example. Then the past form of this main verb will be V2, that is played and went. After that, the past participle form will be verb 3. It can be written as played, gone. Then S and ES forms, where you just add S or ES to the main verb. That is, look at this example, plays, goes. This will take place, or this is used when we are talking about a subject which is singular. ING form, it says verb plus ING and it is written as the main verb plus ING. That's playing and going. So kids, I hope you understood all the forms of the verb here. Now let's continue with tense. So children, what is tense? It is the form taken up by a verb to show the time of an action. So tenses means it is the form of the verb which is taken up by the verb to show the time of the action. Now there are three tenses that we are going to learn today. First is the simple past, the time then, simple present, the time now, then we have simple future, time to come, the time to come. So kids, in today's class we are going to learn about the simple tenses, simple present, simple past and simple future. So students, before we understand the simple present tense, I want you all to take out your English grammar book. Come to page 87. There is a table which is given for us to understand. So this is a table which shows the verb which is written in different forms based on the person, that is first person, second person and third person. So if you look at the table, simple present, I play badminton, we play badminton. Second person, you play badminton. Third person, he or she plays badminton, they play badminton. So if you understand, in the last column, if you look carefully, the verb has taken the S form, right? So whenever the subject is singular, the verb will take up S form. And then when the subject is plural, it is without the S form. So kids, now let's understand what is simple present tense. So kids, simple present tenses, this is an action that occurs on regular basis, comma fact that stands true all the times. It tells us about the situation or an event in the present time. So what do we understand now? It talks about all the regular actions or some routine activities, right? And it also talks about the facts or the general or universal truths. And then look at this, it tells us about the situation or an event in the present time. So whatever is happening right now, it talks about that. So look at the structure of the sentence, how it will be. Structure will be subject plus verb plus object. So verb is in the first form, that is the main form, right? Main verb. I play football regularly. So play is the verb V1 and it is taken up the present form, simple present form. So kids, now let us understand the uses of simple present, which I've already explained. So look at the page 87 of your grammar book. The simple present tense is used to express general or universal truths. For example, the sun rises in the east or the sun sets in the west. Then to describe something that is almost permanent or has been happening for some time and is still continuing. So example, my grandparents live in Kerala. Mrs. Bose is a dance teacher. Next one, it talks about the routine activities. Like for example, the dog barks. Next one, to express future events. Sometimes to express the future events also we use this simple present, which is to express future events that are part of a fixed timetable or a program. And then finally, it has been used in the exclamatory sentences which begin with here or there. So kids, I hope you understood the simple present tense really well. So students, let's quickly recall or recap the points that we learnt under simple present tense. What is a simple present tense? It is an action that occurs on regular basis, fact that stands true all time. It tells us about situation or an event in the present time. So these were the uses of the simple present. And how is the structure of the sentence? The structure is subject plus verb plus object. The example here is, I play football regularly. So this is all about simple present tense. Let's work a few examples. Students, look at the green board now and solve these three questions. She dash four languages. The verb here is speak. So what will be the present tense over here? Yes, you are right. It will be, she speaks four languages. Then next one, Jane is a teacher, she dash French. The verb is teach. So how will you fill the answer? What will be the answer? Yes, you are right. It is going to be teaches. She teaches. T-E-A-C-H-E-S. Then, those shoes dash too much. The verb is cost. So what will be the answer? Those shoes costs. Yes, you're right. Costs too much. So kids, I hope you understood the simple present tense. So kids, the action that is completed before now is the simple past tense. So how does the structure of the sentence look like? It looks like this. Subject plus verb in the second form and the object. Here look at the example. I played football yesterday. So the verb has taken up ed form. So that is the second form. So kids, now let us understand the simple past tense. What is it? It is an action that is completed before now. So this is what it tells, any action that has been completed just now or before now. Okay, so that is subject plus verb to and plus object. This is the structure of the sentence, that is subject plus verb to plus object. So this is the structure of the sentence. Look at the example there. I played football yesterday. I is the subject, played is the verb in the second form, and object football. So kids, now let us understand the uses of the simple past tense. For that, come to page 88 of your English grammar book. So it says, the simple past tense is used to express an action that has already been completed in the past. Example, I received the parcel last week. It snowed yesterday. And also the second use is to express past habits. For example, Rishi meditated for 2 hours every day. Then as a child, Sayani attended yoga classes. So kids, I hope you understood what simple past tenses and their uses. So kids, let's solve one exercise and recall what we learnt under simple past. It was warm, so I dash off my coat. The verb is take. So what will be the answer? In which form? Yes, you are right. It will be in verb 2 form. So that is took. So I took off my coat. Then, I was very tired, so I dashed to bed early. Go. Go. For this, the next form of verb will be went. So here you are going to fill went. Now tell me the answer for this. It's very easy. The vendor dashed in front of our house. The verb is shout. So what did the vendor do? The vendor shouted. Yes, you're right. Shouted in front of our house. So kids, I hope you understood simple past tense. So kids, it's now time for the next tense, that is simple future tense. So kids, simple future tense. So this will talk about an action which will happen in the future. So some action that is going to happen in the future, we use simple future tense. So is the what is the structure of the sentence? That is subject plus will plus verb in the first form with the object. So here, I will play football tomorrow. So here that we have added will, and the verb is in the first main verb form. So kids, now let us understand the uses of simple future tense. I want you to come to page number 88 of your grammar book. So that is to express an action that will take place in the future. For example, Pratap will take a shower in an hour. It will be Eid in a next week. Next, to state what will happen or will be done as a matter of a habit or course. For example, this bus will go to the railway station. Now, besides these uses, there is one more way where we can use the simple future. Instead of using will or shall, we are using be going to. Be going to, and come to page number 89 now. Will be going to. So how will be the structure look like? How will the structure look like? It will look like the subject plus is, am or are plus be going to plus the verb and the object. So children, now I want you to come to page number 89. Besides using shall and will, for example, I shall be going home tomorrow. I will learn swimming the next month. Instead of using will and shall, there is another way to write the future tense. And how is that? That is, we can also use be going to. That is, the structure of the sentence will be subject plus am, is, are plus going to plus the main verb and the object. Look at the example there down. I am going to visit Pune next month. Look at the overcast sky. It is going to rain. So kids, I hope you have understood the simple future tense. It's time for us to quickly recall whatever we have learned. Kids, look at the green board. You earn dash a lot of money. So now we have to fill in the blank in future tense. So how will we write the sentence? You will earn a lot of money. So I'll add will earn a lot of money. Next one, you travel dash around the world. So here also you will use the word will. You will travel. Now last one, you have to repeat the same way and complete the blank. Can you tell me what will be the answer? Yes, you will meet. Very good. So you will meet lots of interesting people. So kids, I hope you have understood the simple future tense. Now it's time for the concluding activity. Kids, now we have to solve this exercise by rewriting the sentences as indicated in the bracket. So first sentence is saying that the baby eats mashed bananas. This is in which tense? It is in simple present tense. Yes. So we have to change it to simple future. So how would you write the answer? Yes, children. How will you write the answer? Yes, you are right. The baby will eat mashed bananas. So I'll write the answer. The baby will eat mashed bananas. So we'll solve two more questions, students. Now look at the second question. Here it says the boy scribbled on the wall. Which tense is this? Yes, this is simple past tense, and we have to change it to simple present tense. So how would we do that? We would simply remove or change the verb over here. So the boy scribbles on the wall will be the answer. Okay. The boy scribbles on the wall. So kids, the next question is the little girl chatters happily. In which tense is it? Yes, chatters is the verb that we have to observe. So which is the tense? Yes, you're right. It is simple present tense, and we need to change it to simple past tense. So how would we write it? We would simply focus on the verb and try to change the verb over here. So the little girl chattered happily is the answer. The little girl chattered happily. So kids, I hope you have understood all the three tenses: simple present, simple past, and simple future. So students, let's quickly recall all that we have learnt and end the session with the mind map. So kids, what did we learn today? The very first thing under the simple tenses we learnt was the verb and their forms. Then we learned the definition of the simple present, simple past, and simple future. We also learned the structure of the three tenses. See, we learned simple present, that is subject plus verb plus object. Second, the simple past, that is subject plus verb 2, or verb in the second form, plus the object. And then we learned simple future, that is subject plus will plus verb 1 plus object. And it also can be written in another way, where we do not use will or shall. So that's subject plus am is are, going to, plus the verb in the first form, and then the object. So this is what we learned under the structure. We also learned the uses of the three tenses. And finally, in the concluding activity, we framed three sentences on simple present, simple past, and simple future. So kids, I hope you all have understood the topic really well. You enjoyed the class. We shall meet again in the next class with a new topic. Until then, you all take care and happy learning.